Welcome to the Love Your Pets podcast, a podcast for pet lovers in Ireland where you get pet tips, news, and interviews. It's educational, it's informative, but most of all, it's fun. Welcome your host, Kate McQuillan.
Welcome, pet lovers, to your weekly episode of the Love Your Pets podcast, brought to you from a freezing cold island. It really is so cold here today. It's actually really weird because when you stand outside in the sun can feel actually quite strong and warm. But out of that sun, it is really cold. Heating fully on, fire lit, everything. You need it all. Now remember, if you want the show notes for this show in your inbox, go to petcitizenisland.com/loveyourpetspodcast, and each week I'll send you the link to the podcast and any notes that go with it. So let's get this show started. So our weekly fun fact for this week is all about dogs. And did you know the reason that dogs curl up is because of an age-old instinct to keep themselves warm and to protect vital organs when they sleep? And I must admit, my dogs do spend most of their time curled up when they're sleeping. When they seem to stretch out is actually when they're on the bed. So they take up as much room as they possibly can. But when they're on the sofa or in their own bed, they're all curled up. So I'm not sure why they like to stretch out when they're in bed. Maybe just so that they can have more of the duvet than me. So in the Poor Time Press this week, I have a couple of stories for you. The first one is actually about a bag which you attach to your dog's tail for them to poop in. And this is actually a Kickstarter campaign, and it means that you no longer need to pick up your dog's poop. That's what they're claiming. You attach the bag to their tail and they can just poop in it anytime they want. And according to the makers, Peekaboo fits all sizes of dog and won't cause them any pain or discomfort. Now, I'm going to include the video for this in the show notes. It's actually quite funny, the video. I can't see any dog wanting that attached to their tail. I can imagine it would be quite annoying. I know Joey would have that ripped off. He'd be running around in circles trying to get it off himself. But it would be interesting to see if it actually does work, or does the poo end up on the outside of the bag, or where does it go? It definitely is a bit of a strange one, that's for sure. So do check out that video. The second story we have then is about a woman in the UK who took the wrong dog home from doggy daycare. Now, I have absolutely no idea how this would possibly happen. I know you can get dogs that are very similar, but surely your dog would have a different colour, or you'd know the personality of your own dog. And seemingly she didn't realise till she got home that her dog was acting differently, and the reason was because it wasn't her dog. It's a bit worrying that a doggy daycare would let someone take the wrong dog. But then it does seem a bit strange that she would take the wrong dog too. So it's all very odd. I wonder how much truth there is actually to the story. Our Paws and Pets shout out this week then is to Dexter, our Nose of Tralee winner. And he had the most amazing photo shoot. I got the chance to go up there and meet him. Absolutely fabulous dog, so friendly, and really loves the camera. Once he got into his photo shoot, he really seemed to enjoy it. And David from David McCauley Photography did an absolutely amazing job of taking some fabulous pictures of him. Some on a white background, some on a black background. They're absolutely fantastic. I'm going to put some of them in the show notes. And I'll put a link as well to David's business. He really is the most patient person in the world. And he did a fantastic job. Now remember, if you want your pets to be internet famous and get a shout out on the show, then post a picture of your pets on Twitter or Instagram using the hashtag #LoveYourPetsPodcast, and each week we'll pick the coolest pets from around the world to feature.
You're listening to the Love Your Pets podcast, sponsored by Pet Sitters Ireland. Planning a trip or need your dog walking? Then contact Pet Sitters Ireland at www.petsittersireland.com for all your pet care needs.
In the spotlight this week, I'm going to be talking about what is a pet sitter and when and why you might use one. So a pet sitter is a pet care professional who comes into your home as many times a day as you need to take care of your pets. So much like you might ask your friends or family to come in and feed your cat or take your dog for a walk while you're away, a pet sitter also provides this service. But the difference between a pet sitter and your friend is that the pet sitter is doing this as their job. They're providing a professional service and they're totally focused on following and maintaining your pet's normal routine. So if your pets normally get fed at 10 a.m. and 6 p.m, then this is what your pet sitter will do for you. They'll follow your exact instructions. So what happens when you decide to use a pet sitter? Well, when you make an inquiry to use the services of a pet sitter, the first thing they will do is ask you about your pets and their routine. They're going to want to know everything about when they get fed, what they get fed, where do you take them for a walk, do you go out of the gate left or right, do you avoid certain dogs on the street, if you have a cat, do you like to have the cat litter changed or do you prefer to scoop every day, what foods do they eat, do they prefer the wet or the dried food or do you give them a mix of food? Are there particular games that you like to play with them? Do you like to leave the TV or the radio on for them? They want to know everything so that they can maintain your pet's normal routine as closely as possible. So once they've got a full understanding of what it is that you want to be done, then they'll help you come up with a schedule of visits that suit you and your pets. So suit the times that they normally get fed, they normally go for a walk. The next step then is to meet your pet sitter at the free meet and greet. And this is a good chance for you to see if the pet sitter is a good match, that you like them and that you feel they can take care of your pets, and most importantly, that your pets like them. In order for you to truly relax and enjoy your holiday, you need to be 100% sure that you're comfortable with your pet sitter. If you're not, then always contact the company to arrange for somebody else to call. It's so important that you get the right person taking care of your pets. We all know that sometimes our animals take to people and not to others, and it's important that you're happy that, you know, everybody's a good match for one another and that your pets are in the best care possible. Now, once you're ready to travel, your visits will commence as scheduled. And remember, office staff will always be checking to make sure every visit is carried out to your requirements and on time, so you don't need to worry about a thing. And after every visit, your pet sitter will send you an email with photos of your pets and notes about what was carried out during the visit, so you can see that your dog was fed, that it was walked, that maybe curtains were closed, maybe the light was left on, and then you can see all those lovely cute pictures maybe of your dog in the back garden playing or lying on the sofa or out on their walk, whatever it is that they were doing with their pet sitter during the visit. Now, why might you use a pet sitter? Now, a pet sitter does a lot more than just take care of your pets, although this is their primary role. So they'll feed your pets, they'll clean and scoop litter, they'll take your dog for a walk, throw a ball for them, play with them, just sit with them if that's what you want. But in addition to those things, your pet sitter will also carry out other tasks to make sure your home looks lived in while you're away. And this is great for additional security. So we can do things like take out the bins, open and close blinds, curtains, turns lights on and off, bring in the post, water plant, carry out home security checks like checking if there was any forced entry, checking if there's any water pipes that are damaged, if you can see any leaks around the house, just have a general sweep of the outside just to make sure that there's nothing untoward. And these can be really invaluable, this service, to make sure that your home and your pets are all safe and sound. So what are the benefits then of a pet sitter to your pets? One of the main benefits is that your pets get to stay at home in their normal surroundings. There's no disruption to their normal routine. They get the same food, they go for the same walks, and they sleep in the same bed as they normally do. Now, I know my two dogs absolutely love their creature comforts. They really do. I can't imagine them being happy going into any other place. They love the sofa, they love their beds, they love their garden, and they love to run in the field. They just like to do the things that they want to do. And having a pet sitter come and take care of our pets when we travel means that they just get to have their own little holiday as well with their pet sitter. They get full one-on-one attention all of the time and they can really enjoy themselves. One of the things that's good for you is it's a lot less hassle and stress. You're not asking friends and family members, you know, there's no worrying about drop-off and collection times that obviously some boarding kennels will enforce. But you come home to happy pets just waiting for you. If you've ever come back off holiday and you've known that you can't pick up your pet till the next day, it's really kind of sad. You come home and you've missed them all holiday, the house feels empty. But with a pet sitter, as soon as you open that front door, there's your pets happy and waiting to see you. Now, as I mentioned earlier, a pet sitter also does a lot to keep your home safe. And this additional home safety check makes sure your home looks lived in, and it's a great benefit to the service. It really is. I know when we've been away before, before we had our pet sitting business, you'd come home and you'd feel, oh gosh, I hope the house is okay, because we live out in a rural area. You know, it's very isolated. Whereas, you know, when you have a pet sitter, you've got that person coming in and out, checking on the house, you know, the heating's on, keeping the place nice and warm and toasty for when you get in. It's just a much nicer experience. So what should you look for in a pet sitter? It's important that your pet sitter is an animal lover. It might seem obvious that they would be, but you need to make sure they interact well with your pets. So can they handle your dog? Are they a cat lover? You know, do they seem to bond well with your pets? I would recommend that you hire a professional pet sitter. This means that it's somebody that's taking their business seriously. They're committed to it 24/7. You want to make sure that they're going to be able to meet your needs, that they're going to be contactable, that they're going to be reliable, and you're not going to be constantly looking for a new pet sitter every few weeks because they've moved on to something new. I'd also recommend that you look for a pet sitter that has insurance. If something happens to your pets, then you want to know that the company's insured. You also want to make sure that the person insured, if they injured themselves on your property. All professional registered businesses will have public liability insurance, so always make sure that you ask about that. You also want to make sure they have a backup plan. This is one of the biggest things that I think people forget. If you're leaving your pets in the care of an individual, then you need to be sure that if something happens to them, that they have a backup plan. For example, if you're halfway across the world and your pet sitter gets sick, you want to know that someone else will be aware of those visits that they're meant to be doing, and that they're going to step in and take care of your pets. People say, oh, I never get sick, nothing ever happens, I'm really reliable. But life, things happen. You know, people get sick, they could be in an accident, something could happen. And you need to make sure that that backup is in place. Nobody wants to have to fly home from their holiday frantic about whether the pet sitter is fed their dog or not. You know, it's something that you really need to make sure. And that it's a professional backup, that it's not just, oh yeah, my friend would step in. You want to know that somebody's going to be checking on this, and that the person belongs to the company that's going to be the backup. Now, I have a great resource for you. They're going to put in a link in the show notes. It's actually a checklist for hiring a professional pet sitter or dog walker, and it gives you all the questions that you need to ask if you're thinking of hiring a company. So do go over to the show notes and download that, and you can print it off. And if you're thinking of hiring someone, you can have that in front of you when you're talking with them.
You're listening to the Love Your Pets podcast, sponsored by Pet Sitters Ireland. Planning a trip or need your dog walking? Then contact Pet Sitters Ireland at www.petsittersireland.com for all your pet care needs.
So I hope that gives you a bit of an insight into what a pet sitter does, and some food for thought around questions that you might want to ask before you go ahead and hire someone. Now, if you want to find out more about our pet sitting service, you can visit petsittersireland.com, and you can either fill out a contact form, or you can call us on free phone 1-800-30-30-10, and we'd love to answer any questions that you might have. Now, this podcast has been sponsored by Pet Sitters Ireland for all your pet sitting and dog walking needs. If you enjoyed it, which I know you did, then please sign up on iTunes to listen every week, and it would be totally awesome if you gave us a review over there. Now, don't forget, you can get the show notes in your inbox each week to save you time at petsittersireland.com/loveyourpetspodcast. And if you're looking for previous episodes of the show, then you can find those all over at loveyourpetspodcast.com. And I'll see you next week. Have a great week.
Thanks so much for listening to the Love Your Pets podcast with your host, Kate McQuillan.